Good morning, students. We had started the chapter Equilibrium of Floating Bodies. Two examples we had discussed. Our next example is a rod of small section and density rho has a small portion of metal of weight 1 by nth of the weight of the rod attached at one extremity. We are to prove that the rod will float at any inclination in a liquid of density sigma if n plus 1 whole square into rho is equal to n square into sigma. So let us consider this denotes a liquid of density sigma. This AB, this is a rod having the center of gravity at the midpoint of the rod, which we have denoted by G. The weight of this rod we have taken as W, which acts at the midpoint G. At this extremity of the rod, a weight is attached, which is 1 by n of the weight of the rod. Weight of the rod is W, so the weight attached here, that is 1 by n of W. Let us take this rod makes an angle theta to the horizontal. This rod AB floats in the liquid such that the portion BC that is outside the liquid. Now, what are the forces acting on this rod? First force, the weight of the rod, which is acting at the midpoint G. And this weight is acting vertically downward. Second force is the weight attached here, which is 1 by nth of the weight of the rod. It also acts vertically downward. And the third force, that will be the force of buoyancy. Force of buoyancy means weight of the liquid displaced, which acts at the midpoint of the immersed part of the rod. Immersed part of the rod is AC. Let us take its midpoint is D. So the force of buoyancy that will act here. And buoyant force always acts in the upward direction. So that will act in this direction. And the buoyant force we have denoted by the force P. So we have three forces. One force weight W. Second force 1 by NW. And the third force is buoyant force. Now, because the rod is in equilibrium, so the resultant of the weight W at the point G and the force 1 by NW at the point A that acts such that that will balance this force P. So we can use the principle of parallel forces. So according to principle of parallel forces, this force into this distance is equal to this force into this distance dg. So finally we have 1 by nw into ad is equal to w into dg. And also because the forces w and 1 by nw, they are acting vertically downward and the buoyant force is acting vertically upward. These two forces are such that they together balance the force P. So we can see that 1 by NW plus W that should be equal to P. Resultant of these two forces that must be same as the force P because the rod is in equilibrium. So we have obtained these two equations. Now we are to find the value of this length AD and also we are to apply the condition of equilibrium. Condition of equilibrium is the weight of the body is equal to weight of the liquid displaced. So first of all, let us find the weight of the body and the weight of the liquid displaced. Now here the body is the rod. So we are to find the weight of the rod. By definition, weight means volume into density into G. Now what is volume of the rod? Volume means length into area of cross sections. Length of the rod we have denoted by 2a and area of cross sections of the rod we have denoted by k. So 2a into k, this is the volume of the road. Density of the road we have denoted by rho, and into g, so we have obtained weight of the road, which is given by 2a into k into rho into g. Now let us find the weight of the liquid displaced. Weight of the liquid displaced means the weight of the immersed part of the road. Immersed part of the road is AC. So the weight of the length AC, that will again be given by the same formula, volume into density into G. Now the volume is length into area of cross sections. Length is AC, area of cross sections is K, density is sigma. Here just keep in mind that you will have to take the density of the liquid, not the density of the road, into G. So we have obtained both. So putting the values of W and P here, from there we will get 2A into K into rho into G into N plus 1 upon N is equal to AC into K into G into sigma. Now from here we can find the value of AD. From the equation 1 also we can find the value of AD. So from here 1 by N into W into AD is equal to W into DG. Now what is DG? From the diagram you can see DG is AG minus AD. AG is, because G is the midpoint, so AG will be half of AB. Total length AB, that is 2A. So AG will be A. So now we can combine the terms in AD from both sides to get the value of AD. So we can substitute the value of AD here. Putting the value of AD here, from here we get the required relation, which is given by rho is equal to N square into sigma upon N plus 1 whole square. So we have obtained the required result. Now our next example is a frustum of right circular cone cut off by a plane bisecting the axis perpendicularly floats with smaller end in the water and its axis is just half immersed. We have to find the specific gravity of the cone and we have to prove that it is 19 upon 56. So let us take a VAB. This represents a right circular cone, and this right circular cone is cut off by a plane. This is the plane which cut off this whole cone such that it bisects the axis. So this plane cuts the cone into two equal parts. Length of this part, that is h by 2. So the length of this part is also h by 2. So this part ABCD, that is the frustum of the cone. And because we are given that the axis of the frustum is just half immersed, it means h by 4 part will be inside the liquid and h by 4 part outside the liquid. So this frustum ABCD floats in such a way. Let us take alpha is the semi-vertical angle of the cone. Now because we are to use the condition of equilibrium, and for that we required the weight of the body. Weight of the body means weight of the frustum ABCD and weight of the liquid displaced. Weight of the liquid displaced means we have to find the volume of the part EFCD. So first of all let us find these two volumes one by one. Volume of the frustum ABCD and the volume of the frustum EFCD, and then we will use the condition of equilibrium. So first of all we find the volume of frustum ABCD. To find its volume you can directly use the formula of volume of frustum, or you can find the volume of this cone and the volume of this cone. Then you can subtract the volumes of the two cones to get the required volume. So first of all, we find the volume of the cone VAB. Volume of cone is given by the formula 1 by 3 pi into radius square into height. The height of this whole cone, that is h, radius we have taken as r1, and r1 can be obtained from the right angle triangle VBP. In the right angle triangle VBP, r1 is the base and this is the r1 is the perpendicular and VP is the base. Perpendicular upon base, that will be tangent alpha. So r1 upon h is equal to tangent alpha. So what will be r1? That will be h into tangent alpha. So we have obtained the radius of the cone VAB. In the same way, you can find the radius of the cone VEF. R2 is the perpendicular. This is the base. Again, perpendicular upon base is equal to tangent alpha. So from there, we can find the value of radius R2. So that will be 3 by 4 h into tangent alpha. And from this right angle triangle, you can find the radius R3. R3 will be given by, this is perpendicular, this is base. So R3 upon this length is equal to tangent alpha. This length is h by 2. So we get R3 is equal to h by 2 into tangent alpha. So we have obtained all the three radii, R1, R2 and R3. Now let us find the volumes of the frustums. So the volume of the frustum A, B, C, D. How we can find this volume? By subtracting the volume of cone VAB and the volume of the cone VDC. So let us subtract these two by the formula. Volume of the cone VAB, that is given by 1 by 3 pi R1 square H. Volume of the cone VDC, that is given by 1 by 3 pi R3 square into the height of this cone, that is h by 2. From here, 1 by 3 pi h, that can be taken out common. So inside we have R1 square minus half of R3 square. We have obtained the values of R1 and R3. So you can put these two values here. So in this way, we have obtained the volume of the frustum ABCD, which is 7 upon 24 times pi h cube tangent square alpha. Now, it remains to find the volume of the liquid displaced. It means volume of the immersed part. And here the immersed part we can see, that is EFCD. It means we are to find the volume of the frustum EFCD. Again, we can see its volume can be obtained by subtracting the volume of the cone VDC from the volume of the cone VEF. So let us find the volume of frustum EFCD. Now the volume of cone VEF, this is 1 by 3 pi into radius square into height. The height of the cone VEF, that is 3 by 4 h, and radius is R2. And here the height of the cone VDC, that is h by 2, and radius is R3. So putting the values of R2 and R3 here and simplifying, you can obtain the volume of the frustum EFCD, which is 19 upon 192 into pi h cube into tangent square alpha. Now let us use the condition of equilibrium. So weight of the body is equal to weight of the liquid displaced. Weight of the body means weight of the frustum ABCD, and weight of the liquid displaced means volume of the frustum EFCD. So we can equate the two volume weights. Weight means volume into density into g. Volume of the frustum ABCD is 7 by 24 pi h cube tangent square alpha. Density we have taken as rho dash into g. And here also volume is 19 upon 192 pi h cube tangent square alpha, and density is rho into g. So from here g is cancelled from both sides, and we can find the value of specific gravity. By definition, specific gravity is given by density of the substance upon density of standard substance. Here the substance is cone, and its density we have taken as rho dash. And density of standard substance, standard substance here is water, and density of water we have taken as rho. So rho dash upon rho, that will become s. So specific gravity is obtained from here, which is 19 upon 56. Now our next example is a thin hollow cone with base floats completely immersed in water wherever it is placed. Show that the vertical angle of the cone is 2 times sine inverse 1 by 3. Now, because here the cone is completely immersed in the water, so the center of gravity of the displaced liquid will be same as the center of gravity of the solid cone. Now, what is the center of gravity of the solid cone? This is the base, this is the vertex. OA is the axis of the cone. If we take the length of the axis as h, then the center of gravity of the cone that lies at 1/4 of this total height from the base. It means the center of gravity of the cone is h by 4, means this length OG. This will be the distance of center of gravity of the cone from O. This is h by 4. Here will be the center of gravity of the cone. Now, we can find the center of gravity of the cone by using the formula, because we can consider this cone to be divided into two parts. One part is the curved surface and another part is this circular base. So we can use the formula: center of gravity of the cone is equal to area of the curved surface into OG1 plus area of the circular base into its distance from the point O upon the total area. Total area means the area of the curved surface plus area of the base. Now putting the values, OG1 is the depth of center of gravity of the curved part, curved surface from O, which is h by 3, and this distance of the center of gravity of circular base from the point O, that is 0, because the center of gravity of the circular area lies at the point O, and the area of the curved surface of the cone is pi r l, area of circle is pi r square. So from here we also obtained center of gravity of the cone, which is lh upon 3 into l plus r. Also the center of gravity of the cone, that is h by 4. So we can equate the two values of the center of gravity of the cone. By equating the two values, from here h is cancelled from both sides. After simplifying this term, we get l is equal to 3r. From here r upon l is equal to 1 by 3. Now in this right angle triangle, you can see that what is r upon l. R upon l means perpendicular upon hypotenuse, that is sine of alpha. So we get sine alpha is equal to 1 by 3. So from here alpha will be sine inverse 1 by 3. So we have obtained the vertical angle of the cone, which is 2 alpha. So 2 times of sine inverse 1 by 3. So this gives us the vertical angle of the cone. Now our next example is a cone 7 inch in height and 2 inch in diameter is attached adds its base to a hemisphere of equal diameter. The specific gravity of cone is 3/2 and of hemisphere is 7/4. We are to find the specific gravity of the liquid in which body would sink till 3 inches of axis of the cone is out of the liquid. Now, here we are having two parts of the compound body. One is cone and second is hemisphere. First of all, let us find the densities. Let us take the density of standard substance is rho, because we are given the specific gravity of cone as well as hemisphere, so we can find their densities. If we take the density of the cone to be rho 1, then that is given by 3/2 into the density of standard substance. Density of standard substance is rho, so the density of the cone, that will be 3/2 times of rho. In the same way, because the specific gravity of hemisphere is 7/4, so its density will be 7/4 into rho. Let us take the radius of the base of the cone and hemisphere is r, because 2 inches the diameter, so radius will be 1 inch. Now you can see that this is hemisphere and this is the cone attached. So this is a compound body consisting of two parts, and we have considered equilibrium for this body. So weight of the liquid displaced will be same as the weight of this compound body. So let us find the two values one by one, and by equating them we will get the specific gravity of the water displaced. Now let us take sigma be the density of the liquid. S is the specific gravity of the liquid in which the body floats. So by definition of specific gravity, we can find the value of sigma, which is rho into S. Now let us find the weight of this body. Weight of this body will be weight of the cone plus weight of the hemisphere. Weight of the cone means volume into density into G. Volume is 1/3 pi r square into h. Here the height of the cone is 7. Density is rho 1 into gravity is G. Volume of hemisphere is 2/3 pi r cube. Density is rho 2 into G. R is 1 here, so putting the value here, we get the weight of this compound body, which is 14/3 pi rho G. Now let us find weight of the liquid displaced. Weight of the liquid displaced means weight of the immersed part. Immersed part is this part. It means we are to find the weight of this frustum and the weight of hemisphere. So let us find volume of hemisphere and the volume of the frustum, and that is added and multiplied with density into G. Density of the liquid is sigma, gravity is G. Volume of hemisphere is 2/3 pi r cube, and the volume of the frustum EFBC, that can be obtained by subtracting the volume of cone AEF from the volume of the cone ABC. Now volume of the cone ABC, that is 1/3 pi r square into the height, which is 7 inch, and the volume of this part, that is also a cone, its volume will be 1/3 into pi into radius square into height. Height is 3 and the radius we have denoted by r1. Now let us find the value of r1 and putting here. To find the value of r1, we can use the concept of similarity of the triangles. The triangle AOE, that is similar to the triangle AOC. This point is O dash. So the triangle AO dash E will be similar to the triangle AOC. So the ratio of their corresponding sides will be same. If we take O dash E, which is R1, and OC, which is R. So R1 upon R will be this height upon this height. This height is 3 inch and the height AO, that is 7 inch. So we get R1 upon R is equal to 3 by 7. So from here, R1 will be 3 by 7 times of R. R is 1. So we can substitute the values here. So we have obtained weight of the liquid displaced. Now we can substitute the two values in the conditions of equilibrium. Weight of the body is equal to weight of the liquid displaced. Now we can cancel out the like terms. Rho and G are cancelled from both sides. Pi is also cancelled. So we get the value of the specific gravity, which is given by 343 upon 207. So this completes the examples of the first exercise. Two examples I have left for you. You will see the examples. If you have any doubt, we will discuss them in your doubt class.